朝鮮って我々松田がずっと大事にしてきたもので、いわば伝統のようなものです。過去13回の朝鮮を経て、1991年に日本メイクとして初めて、しかも松田しか持たないパワートレインの大谷エンジンでル・マンで総合優勝しました。その時の感動は本当に今でも忘れられません。これが挑戦だと思いました。
Design from a heritage standpoint, obviously we looked at cars like the 787. That car has this amazing long front overhang, really short, low rear end, and it creates this very unique balance that's just not commonplace in contemporary sports cars. So we wanted to take that influence and bring it into this new concept and create this dramatic proportion where you have really low front end, very dynamic, sculpted fender treatments, and then really low rear end.
This Gran Turismo project, all the designers got involved in it, was a global competition, and we all pitched our ideas, but ever since the beginning, I wanted to pitch this Le Mans race car. Mazda has such a strong Le Mans history. My project was to recreate that Le Mans car for the future 2020.
My design もずっとチャレンジし続けています。今我々が取り組んでいるのは、フォドというデザインテーマ。それは生命感あふれる美しいフォルムを作ること、車に命を吹き込む、これが我々デザインの挑戦です。
Welcome back to Gran Turismo 6. It's time to drive Mazda LM55 Vision Gran Turismo. And in the last video, I forgot to show the Lexus LFLC video. But don't worry, I already put the video link of the unveiled one. Okay? Let's go to Dream Car Championship.The LM55 F means fantastic LMP car, not a failure. Okay, don't even think F is a failure. No, F is for fantastic LMP car. Yeah, let's race. There's Jaguar XJR9, BMW BLU.Feet of LMR. Fun fact, this car is a four-wheel drive LMP, not MR. Surprised? Also, the video released on 25th December 2014. Yeah, last video, day number 5, and now day number 6 of Easter. Modern generation of LMP. I've changed. take it all around. Look at all of this thing for me. The ticket balloon, and you want to understand it for me. There's a time when you step aside. 3 lemon cars plus 1. This lemon car, that means there are 4 lemon cars. 3 lemon prototypes. There you go, finish. Hang on, I'm just fix my controller because he goes to the right slightly a bit there for no reason. Next race, Willow Springs for 4 laps. Nine point eighty-two miles. goes to the right again. No reason there. Don't worry, I will fix it again. I think it has 8 speed for this thing. Final turn, run to the finish. Victory! Yeah. Okay guys. Now we're going to the next race at Cape Ring. Touch it up, what am I doing? Getting away. Is it possible? What am I trying to tell? My way, getting away, getting away. I just went to the red there. But that was really, really cheeky move there by me. Yeah, it has 8 speed. What is LMP? Oh god! Oh, the screen went off. For no reason there. Out of nowhere. When you put on 1080p, yeah, sometimes the screen went off there. That one includes the part where I was playing FIFA 15. Okay. Yeah, sudden interruption there. Take it easy in the spiral bridge. Oh, I cannot hold on. Somehow I cannot hold on there. A little scratch, no worries. and done. Alright. Next race, Cirque de la Sarthe. Crash because of that disability set, tries to block the right lane there. Little scratch on the left side of the Mazda. Oh God. Oh no! Oh, 224 miles per hour. 225 miles per hour. Okay, I overtook him, but I cut the corners kind of bit there. Almost got to the gravel there. Oh my, my. One more lap to go at Le Mans. I went too fast on the ticking engines. chicken, run to the finish. Boom, bada boom. Yeah. Alright guys, so next and the last one at Nürburgring 24-hour circuit. 24-hour track of Nürburgring. So the next event, Gran Turismo World Championship. After that, Spa-Francorchamps 24-minute race. Later, 24 minutes of Le Mans. Oh, I went to the grass for the right tires there. I need to find the opening. Come on, find the opening. Where's the opening? Oh god. Oh god. I don't wanna do the aggressive overtaking to him there. Make it through. Oh geez. Final lap. Let's go. God, this is gonna hurt a little bit. Hit a tire barrier there. Oh jeez. I just lost control on that corner. Yeah. When you guys are using the racing hard tires, yeah, that's the reason why. When you're going too fast, you are going understeer. A little bit there. Thank you. Experiment off. You're going straight. Oh God. Oh. Oh man, just hit the tire barrier there. Alright. A good win. A clean sweep as well. Yeah. Okay. $115,000. All right. Let's go to Gran Turismo World Championship. Gran Turismo World Championship is next. After that, Spa-Francorchamps 24-minute race, and then Le Mans. Dream cars, and yeah, we're up against Wexler here, the Cyber Mercedes C9, the driver from Like the Wind. Let's race. And Yu Haas from Dream Car Championship. Dream Car Championship racer. C. Lewandowski from Like the Wind, as well as Wexler too. First race, Mount Panorama for 4 laps. Pits, yeah, pits as well, I do believe, from Like the Wind. Smet as well. Smet, Lewandowski, Wexler. And Nishida. Nishida Zielinski. Mm-hmm. Alright, so next race, what attack race with Laguna Seca. After that, circuit to Spa Francorchamps. Later, Silverstone. That was close. I put too much trouble on that corner before Armor All sponsor there. And yeah, I somehow managed to avoid it before it's too late there. And Zielinski finished second. Ah, then. Okay. We're going to WeatherTech race with Laguna Seca for the next race. six laps at WeatherTech Raceway Laguna Seca. Okay, just me against Zielinski. Finish. Two wins in a row. Yeah. Okay. We are going to the next race. We're going to Spa-Francorchamps. I turned too early there and then hit that guardrail. Okay, I gotta be careful before entering the E-Rouge. Gotta be careful, okay? Belgian Grand Prix track. There you go, that's smooth. Very smooth. Oh, we got, hang on. Oh, we got a live stream here from Cake. Oh jeez. Okay, didn't get me noticed for that. Draw something. Hang on.
Okay. As you can tell by the title, it's been a while since I've done Hey, Matthew, welcome to the stream. And it's been a while since I've done an art stream. Alright, we're getting out of the team. It's been a while since I've done art stream, I believe. as a motivation pretty much goes out the window when it comes to, you know, everything. But here's what I'm currently working on. I'm currently working on my new Cookie Run Kingdom OC. Her name is Cosmic Cola Cookie. She currently already does have a design, but she doesn't really have sprites. I already finished up the line work. All I gotta do now is the coloring. And this is her current design, but I kind of want to do something different with the outfit since, you know, I'm not really that happy with it. Hey, yo, Starfire, Spork, Alex, welcome to the stream. Welcome to the stream, everyone. Welcome to the stream. And if any of you do know much, like, obviously, I'm pretty sure not a lot of you know about Cosmic Cola Cookie, but she was originally inspired by, hey, yo, baby, welcome to the stream. If tests are testicles, what are exams? That's a good question. Look it up on Google, I don't know. She's cute. Thank you. She was originally inspired by an enamel pin that I have on my backpack with the same name, Cosmic Cola. I have shown it before on my live streams, but yeah. It's basically, you know, just a little cup, it's a little can of soda that has, you know, little cosmic moons and clouds in it, which I thought was really cute. So, yeah, I decided, you know what, why not make that into a cookie? Originally, in Cosmic Cola Cookie's backstory, she was originally supposed to be Blueberry Pie Cookie's apprentice. I still really do like the idea of her being Blueberry Pie Cookie's apprentice. I want to do something a little bit different, though. How about instead of her being, you know, her apprentice, what about we do, like, a mail carrier? Because, come on, there isn't really any mail carrier. Not mail. Mail. Mail carriers. Like, you know, the mailman. Stuff like that. I'm so dumb. Something like that. I haven't really seen many cookie characters that actually have that kind of concept. So I thought, hey, why not just give it to Cosmic Cola Cookie? Because, you know, a lot of people in my comments when I posted the picture of Cosmic Cola Cookie right here, a lot of people said, is she friend? Like, a lot of people had the assumption that she was friends with Milky Way Cookie, which, yes, she canonically is friends with Milky Way Cookie. However, having her just be the, you know, friends with her, I feel like it didn't really make much sense, if that makes any sense. I wanted them to have, like, this strong sister bond with each other, and, you know, just them existing on the train, you know, Milky Way Cookie's train, it didn't really make much sense to me. I originally thought, hey, why not have, you know, Milky Way Cookie drive the Cosmic Cola Cookie to, Blueberry Pie Cookie's, observatory. But then I thought, no. That wouldn't make much sense now, would it? So I thought, you know what, why not just make her a mail carrier instead, and, have her go on these wacky adventures with, Milky Way Cookie and Space Dust Cookie. If you don't know who Space Dust Cookie is, he is a new cookie in Cookie Run Kingdom who is Moonlight Cookie's brother. I absolutely adore his design. He looks so beautiful. He's so pretty. Let's say goodbye, Kitchen. Alright, see you, dude. She looks like Alchemist Cookie. She does actually kind of look like Alchemist Cookie. I do see that. I think the reason why you might think that is because, you know, space buns. The reason why I just gave her space buns is, you know, they're space buns. I like space buns. But the worst thing is about me is that I will never put space buns in my hair. Why? I don't like having pins in my hair, man, okay? I just really like having pins in my hair because it hurts my scalp. I have sensitive scalp when I'm a pussy, but... considered a mistake by the wizards. It was abandoned. He was literally slingshotting into fucking space and tried to destroy the, what was it? Descendant of Wizards. Yeah. Yeah, I don't know what the hell. Fuck. Like, bro. Motherfucking got slingshotted into space and tried to come back and destroy everything. I mean, I don't blame him at all, though. I don't blame him. I would probably do the same thing. After being slingshotted into space, I would 100% just lay waste to the people who have wronged me. Just bend them over my knee and spank them. I'm such an idiot, man. I'm such a dumbass. Slingshot like an angry bird. You're not wrong. He legit was slingshot in his face like a fucking angry bird. Look at him go.
Yeah. Your discretion is advised because it will contain bad words for this summer.
So I have seen this new little ship coming around out of technically kind of nowhere where people have started a ship. Who is it? Unicorn Cream Cookie with Space Test Cookie. Honestly, I kind of see it happening, even though I headcanon again Space Test Cookie is Arrow Ace. I must spread my Arrow Ace agenda to you all. Wanted to give her little stars in her inner eye, you know, little hair. Apparently with, so... Ayo, Bird Gaming! Bird Gaming! Just like our taco cookie. I know it's out of topic. Nah, man, it's alright, bro. I was just about to mention Dark Taco Cookie, because, you know, it isn't a Kink Chan stream without mentioning Dark Taco Cookie at least once. Because, goddammit, again, that cookie deserves the world. And I'd be more than happy to conquer it for him. Like, bro, he didn't even need to ask me. He just, like, he just exists. And I'm just like, I'll conquer the world for you. I'll definitely do that for you. Call me as simple you want, bro. He deserves it. It's like, Pastra with Baby Bendy. If you don't know who Pastra is, he's, a YouTuber who is an avid fan of Bendy and the Machine, and Bendy and the Dark Rival. And, I've watched him live stream, him playing Bendy and the Dark Rival, which, by the way, he actually got, a copy of Bendy and the Dark Rival from the Meatly himself. Dude, I'm so fucking jealous. I'm beyond jealous of him, like, bro. If only I had that kind of privilege, man. If only, just bro, that'd be so... Still can't believe I made a new fleshed out OC just because you sent me... Dark Taco Cookie does deserve the world. He does, honestly. And I'd be more than willing to give it to him. God, my neck is itchy. My back is itchy. Everything is itchy. Mostly just my back, though. Oh, yeah, I watched this video on the mysterious house in Hello Neighbor. Yeah, like, Hello Neighbor sucks large amounts of lore ass. Bro, I don't understand why it's so popular. It started out good, but then, they had to throw in lore. I mean, dude, this is the kind of game that works without lore, in my opinion. I mean, like, come on. Did you really have to throw in lore for Hello Neighbor? It's just a neighbor being snooty as fuck about their other neighbor, and the other neighbor's like, get the fuck out of my house. Hey, I like Hello Neighbor. I'm not saying you can't like Hello Neighbor. I personally don't care for Hello Neighbor. I think it's kind of dumb, but you do you. It's like how some people say that Benny and Machine is uttering complete garbage when if you genuinely think that you are fucking wrong, in my opinion. But that's their opinion. I'm not saying you can't like, what was it? The Hello Neighbor. It's like how you're allowed to hate, the word King Chan doesn't mention Dark Chuck and the Fiona stream. Who are you? What have you done with Lexi? Exactly. If I ever do not mention Dark Chuckle at all on a live stream, it's not me. It's not. It's definitely not me. That's a fact about me. I do not go without talking about Dark Chocolate Cookie at least once in my day. You think I'm lying? I'm not, honestly. I'm not lying. I have a problem. I have a genuine problem. Who was the bigger Semi?
That was hilarious.
Who was the bigger Semi or Usla's Cash App for Dark Cow? That's honestly a great question. We should do like a Sim fight. We should do that honestly. If Cash App is ever watching this, first of all, I'm incredibly honored because I love their art. And also, we should fight. We should honestly fight. Not really fight, because I already know damn well he probably would beat my ass, but, like a mom, though, we should fight. Fight over who is the biggest sim for the emos. Man, I think how the neighbor should have sort of, the lore should have worked, but the way it was handled was trash. Yeah, I would watch that. Me too, I definitely would watch that. Yeah, I myself would watch that shit show. Kind of like with Willy Wonka, like Johnny Depp's Willy Wonka in Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. Like at the beginning of the movie, when the shit starts, he's just like, that notorious scene where the puppets catch on fire, and instead of being on the throne, he's right. He's just in the crowd, just clapping his hand, being like. That's amazing. I mean, honestly, if I put that shit all together, I definitely would want to watch it. So I get that all correct. Yeah. Okay, I may need to put this in its own separate folder since I don't want to get it all mixed up with anything. That would be a TV show. Lex, Ew, Pig, welcome to the stream. I want to watch the Kimetsu animated series. Me too. It looks so good from what I'm looking at, from what I've seen. Honestly, I love the 2000 Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. It is great. It's such a great film. It sucks that no one is giving it the credit that it deserves, because you motherfuckers are just blinded by your love of nostalgia. Myself included, honestly. But then again, I never even watched Gene Wilder's Willy Wonka. Yeah, you can call me uncultured all you want, but I personally just don't really care for that version. But dude, I will admit though, that Gene Wilder is fucking hilarious.
Such a mood in the movie, and I love him
for
it. We all love
him for it. We all miss Gene Wilder. I miss him. Rest in peace, man. You deserve it. He deserved the world. He just showed me the world. Rest in peace for him. Splendid. Yeah, peace for him. Splendid. Yeah, 7700. This bitch-ass motherfucker is a goddamn YouTube channel with no subscribers. I hope it stays that way.
This. Fucking
this
asshole.
Bitch, thinks he's doing something with his life, being cool, edgy, by threatening my life and making this dumbass.
Uncertain double zero. This fucking asshole who tried to hurt my friends.
Dude. Oh, we clouded on Uncertain Z. You threatened my life too for defending y'all. Let's fucking go. I think Uncertain is hella funny. I hope he gets more. Yes, he should. Lexi.exe real. Holy shit, I got a doppelganger. Let's fucking go, bros. Like, bro, this motherfucker thinks he's doing something with his life. Meanwhile, him, he's just. Bruh. He's just writing out that gap between his teeth as a parking space for ants. Like, bro, what the fuck? Sit your ass down. No one likes you, no one cares about you. You know, at least my parents wanted me. At least my parents adopted me for a reason. You were a fucking failed abortion. Just accept the fact that, you know. Can't get pissed off. True. True as fuck. Like, bro. He's mad at me fucking creep. You're a creep, you know that? You're worse than fucking Sneeko. Yeah, you know that bitch who's been crying about Voice Critical roasting the shit out of him? Yeah, he's like him. You know, I don't know about you, but I think him and EDP would be just great ass friends, man. They're both fucking weirdos and creeps. Okay, Ezra needs to hop onto this stream because that would be pure con. Yes! Yes. If only I didn't block him, though. I don't know how blocking works on YouTube, but I can still see his shit. I don't know. But goddammit, it'd be so funny if he actually just come down here.
Norbert like, Rain 24 hours.
If he actually did come out here, I'd put that bitch in his place. Like, bro, you're not doing anything with your life. Your fucking mistake is sitting in your goddamn house thinking, like, oh my god. Oh yeah. I'm trying to make peace with Uncertain, but no, he's a fucking creep. This bitch-ass motherfucker thinks he's gonna threaten my life, bro. How the hell do you even know where I live, man? I don't even know where I live. We live nowhere. Nothing is real. And also, the funnier thing in here, too, is just, how the fuck are you gonna get past my fucking parents, bro? Like, and just, we all know. You're not gonna get to me. You're not gonna fucking get to me. And besides, I wanna die anyway. I've been giving you just thank you. Thank you so much. You threatened my life, bro. And I'm just here like, oh yeah, I'm waiting. Keep chatting context moment. I'm still in the camp of super innocent about the same person, and you can't prove me otherwise. Honestly though, I do kinda think they are probably the same person, because super Lexi lives in Mario Party 2. Nah, bro, I don't live there. I live in the fucking ink machine and Benny in the ink machine. Duh, don't you know that? Oh wait, shit, I self-docked myself, man. God damn it. You're gonna have to have, you know, whatever the fuck his name is, drag you into your goddamn Game Boy. Let's fucking go, bros. This. Oh, hell yeah. Yeah. Just man. He has to be the fattest L in existence. Like, he is the living embodiment of a fucking L, bro. And that's not a compliment in any way possible. That never even was a compliment. Like, what the fuck am I saying? I'm just gonna go ahead and just merge all these together.
Identify as a fucking frog. He probably is one of those bitches out there. But yeah, I identify
fuck you to the moon, bro. Like, get the fuck out of here. I like being a little more sophisticated myself.
Exactly.
Like, he is the living definition of I don't go outside. I mean, come on, man. Give your own ass a break. Give the dildo a break. Just, God have mercy on his dildo collection in his goddamn house. Even if he lives under a house, or even if he lives under a bridge, just God have mercy on those dildos he has in his house. If he even does have one. Just, or better yet, God have mercy on his parents. Because imagine being that kid's parents and finding out, oh my God, our kid's a fucking creep. Honey, give me the shotgun. We already knew. I told you not to smoke weed. I told you not to drink and smoke crack when you were pregnant. I identify as a problem at 0-0. Nah, man, he identifies as an unsolved Rubik's Cube. He identifies as an unsolved Rubik's Cube. I'm such a terrible person, and I don't fucking care. Let me try and get a more different color. Something like this, but more purple. Yeah. I want to give her a different outfit since her outfit currently is kind of dumb. I want to give her more, like, purples. Seems to be, like, the far right perp who identifies as an attack helicopter. Hey, that's me! The fact he uploaded about Charles getting killed and added a knife made it look like he stabbed me in his face. I just weren't worrying about... I just put that out based on immature content about the nightmares that I made. Naruto just took it without any caring about it. I personally just don't give a shit. That motherfucker stole what kind of banner was it? Some birthday banner that the good one made for me. By the way, adorable banner. I love this banner. I love his art too. Just go check out his go check him out. He makes really good art. And all you horny fucks out there, he does make NSFW too.
Oh man, that was not a good run into that corner of the chicane. Corner
man,
into chicane there.
Uh-huh.
I just went too fast.
Man, sit your ass down. No one gives a flying shit about you. Ew. The good one made fun of me. And he said that I'm such a
okay. Alright. Final touch. And then we're gonna do another lap. So let's go.
So after this, we can definitely watch maybe episode 15 and 16, since I haven't really finished watching the entire story happening.
Oh.
Like,
Cookie Run Kingdom episode 15 and 16.
Episode 16, so I don't, really
I don't make it
the
to the City of Wizards yet.
Episode 15, though, but I definitely speed
as well as the Dream Express.
Because I wanted to watch the...
Ow.
I wanted to watch the entire thing go down during a live stream,
oh,
so that's
God.
Kind of why
oh
I
my
really...
God. Oh my God, that was really, really
there
bad driving there.
Wait, do you do pixel art at all? Oh yeah, I love doing pixel art. It is kind of you know, time-consuming a little bit because the pixel art program that I use doesn't really work the same as IBI's Kinect does, but I'm pretty sure IBI's Kinect does do pixel art, so I need to get some new brushes for pixel art, though.
Not fast enough
yeah,
on that,
that
corner.
Was a really long ass time ago because right now I'm not really into Henry's because I love doing pencil art. It's very fun. Oh wait, I forgot the line for eyelashes. Eyelashes, fuck.
I just caused a couple of times for the fails. Okay, Cyber Machine is C9, finished second.
It's one of the worst things when it comes to drawing in the Cookie Run Kingdom art style. It's deciding on color. A complicated song is great. Oh yeah, Word Crimes is good. It is a good one. I love Word Crimes. It's one of the first songs I ever got introduced by when it came to Weird Al. One of the first songs I ever listened to when it came to him. By the way, great song. It's a good song. I'm gonna decide which one's
200k. Yeah, let's go. Now it's 24 minutes races. Two 24 minute races starting at Circuit de Spa-Francorchamps.
Stop gambling, is gambling is cringe, but at the same time it still was kind of good to gamble your gems away, because now you have a fucking timeline, a timeline of all the cookies that you can get from recent release to whatever. And the worst part, Dark Choco, my beloved, is not even on that scale yet, even though I do already have him at full power.
I'm gonna go with B-Spec for this one. I'm gonna test this thing out. Is it working or not on the B-Spec mode? Hopefully it works, okay?
That was quick. That was a good dive there.
Okay, bro. Also, the fact Dark Tower is a nightmare in the training. Chuck's boss. It's sad. And it
oh,
he wants me to
a shortcut there.
Get their chocolate comforts dad because he knows about how. Yeah. Honestly, though, I am actually gonna hopefully bring back the ghoul for Dark Cacao because I want to see that go down. Honestly, I want to see that go down. You know, should I do it with, instead of like yellow for the little purse, little bag, which needs all the little letters, should I do pink or yellow? I think maybe pink. Let me try pink. Do like a lighter pinkish pink.
Ah, shortcut, I'm kidding.
I have
all three as well.
I am Dark Cacao, Holly Berry, and Pure Vanilla. And I'm still waiting for sisters to release, what's her face? I'm still waiting for them to release Ghoul and Cheese Cookie, because it's becoming a meme at this point in the fandom where everyone's like, yeah, she's not coming, she's not coming. I think they're just doing that on purpose at this point.
Oh no. Okay.
Yeah, golden cheese. Yeah, golden cheese. Wait, I see Lara? Wait, I see Lara's here? Where did I see
Lara?
Oh,
bruh. What was that? That was a fail.
I can't
that was a
like,
fail.
Oh, that sucks ass, man. I'm sorry. That does suck. That does suck. Holy shit. We're just about done with Cosmic Cola. All I gotta do now is just color in just detail her eyes, because she is baby. And again, for some reason, I feel like she sound like guys from the Mater's in them. The last Asian cookie would probably be White Lily Cookie, and the next would be Golden Cheese. I mean, it would make a shit ton of sense if they decided to release Golden Cheese. Like, you know, not Golden Cheese, White Lily last, because come on.
Okay, guys, I just left the stream because Kate and the others are watching episode 15 and 16 of The City of Wizards, since I have not reached episode 15 and 16, yeah, I just want to stay away for a while because I don't want to cut spoilers, and yeah. Also, yeah, she just finished drawing Cosmic Cola Cookie. Yeah. A couple of minutes left. already 12 p.m. here, and we're gonna have lunch after the recording. The last one will be at Le Mans, okay? Again, not gonna refill much. I mean, refill a little bit. We gotta do one more lap to go, guys. Yeah. But Gustafsson made it to the finish line before entering the pit there. So I'm gonna run this track one more time. Yeah. Gustafsson just slowed down like that. One more lap over Gustafsson. All right then. Next race, we're going to Le Mans, the last one to do the 24-minute race, okay? So, let's go fly to France again. Circuit de la Sarthe is the last one. Oh boy, there's Nishida, Piper, Ishida. Oh, Nishida and Ishida, okay. What with N, one without N. And what track again? Okay. And let's go for respect one last time. That's the Jaguar XJ13 here. Oh, shortcut penalty. That was unexpectedly random. Slide out there. They are pitting. Strange, they are pitting so early there. Except for Piper and Bartelemy and Savidis. Thank you.
I'm a radio superstar.
Pfeiffer is fitting in. Okay. Time to push hard. Let's go. Alright. Entering the pit lane one more time. And let's go for 50 liter fuel. Go, one more to go, lap 7.
And you're a master, you're in my way, disaster. Is it possible?
Mazda LM55 Vision GT is the best. Yeah. Let's go. Next car for the Vision GT cars, Toyota FT1 Vision Gran Turismo. Also, tribute to Kiichiro and Soichiro Toyota. Yeah, Kiichiro was the founder of Toyota and they had passed away there. And yeah,
I gave them the tribute. For Choichiro, yeah. He passed away at the age of 97. Well, his birthday was February 27, 1925, almost his 98th birthday for Soichiro. Yeah. Chairman of Toyota Motor Corporation from 1994 to 99. Alright, so yeah, giving tribute to Kiichiro and Soichiro, father and son. Okay? Thank you for watching this video. Subscribe to my channel, my second channel, and Kei-chan's channel. My second channel and Kei-chan's channel, the links are in the description. If you want to join my commentary videos, don't forget, join my Discord server, okay? If you are really interested. Okay? The links, well, in the description. As always. Okay, thank you for watching. I'll see you guys in the next gameplay. Goodbye for now.